almost heaven. West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains growing.
Today on Where in West Virginia is Mr. Casto. We're right here in Milton, West Virginia, about 30 miles from Charleston, West Virginia. We're gonna check out a local food favorite in Blenko Glass. Let's check it out.
While in Milton, West Virginia, there's no better way to start your day than the homemade way, right here at Tudor's Biscuit World.
Tudor's Biscuit World's been in the area since 1980, and it started about 30 miles down the road in Charleston, West Virginia. Let's see what they have to offer.
This West Virginia favorite offers a breakfast, lunch, and dinner menu. They serve sandwiches, burgers, and all of your breakfast favorites, including their made-from-scratch biscuits. They have nearly 20 biscuits to choose from. And while you're trying some amazing food, you might as well have some of the best sweet tea in the area.
Better place to eat this biscuit than right here in front of the Mud River Covered Bridge. It's built in 1875, across the Mud River at 112 feet long. It's over here in Public Park today in Milton. Let's check out this Duke. See how it tastes. I've had this many times before. It is my favorite.
The Duke is an amazing biscuit that has bacon, egg, cheese, and yes, a hash brown on top.
Check them out. All right, after getting filled up by that great biscuit at Tudor's Biscuit World, we're right here at Blenko Glass Company. It was started in 1893 by William Blenko, and it moved to Milton in 1921. Today, they're gonna give us special access to see how everything's made. Let's check them out.
On this episode, we will be given exclusive access to Blenko Glass Company by site operations director, Dave Wirtz.
So it all starts right here. So we get our sand trucked in. We actually get our sand from Michigan. It's actually cheaper to get it here due to logistics costs. Sand, soda ash, and lime. Makes about 90% of the volume of our glass batch itself. And we add about a handful of chemicals that make up the color. Some people think we take blue glass, melt it down, make blue vases. No, we start with the raw ingredients.
Blenko prides itself in being the most colorful name in glass, with over 1,500 colors, each with its own individual recipe.
But everything starts with fresh black wood.
We have block wood, draw your center line on both pieces. Draw it out, start carving out.
I can make more like it today.
It makes ribs in the pumpkin.
Cut down, kind of plunge it in. Somebody else will come around at just the right time with that bit on top. And you'll see the little kind of striations on there. They call that an optic. So they'll dip it in, stick it on the top, cut him off.
Historically, Blenko has had multiple designers over the years. We don't have any right now, kind of by design. The guys on the floor have such a good eye for this stuff that if we need a new piece or whatever. So for instance, the New River Gorge is now a national park. So Daniel, our master moldmaker, has taken upon himself to create a piece inspired by the New River Gorge Bridge. You put them up sideways like that, kind of mimics the same arch and everything else as the NRG.
Dean Six, our general manager, was sitting at a restaurant. We still have the initial inspiration. He started drawing mushrooms on his menu. And so he still has things like Giovanni's Reparo there, the original kind of mushroom shape that he wanted. And of course, Daniel takes it to Tracy Luke and does his thing.
It can take between 30 to 36 hours after the ingredients are added for the glass to be ready to be gathered. The heat varies by what color is being made, but can be over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Oven number 5 today is set up for emerald glass. From there, the teamwork begins around the hot room. After the initial gather, the glass is handed off to be shaped into a ball before he then will add a little bit of air inside of it so that it can be worked into other shapes. After making it into a ball and adding the air, it's then blown into a mold to shape it. The mold is made of cherry wood and is soaked in water until it's ready so it keeps it from catching fire. Mold blowing has been around for over 2,000 years. This technique allows the glass makers to speed up the production process. At this point, it's removed from the mold and worked to get the piece to the precise shape desired. These tools are owned by the glass makers themselves and are traditionally passed down as they have been for thousands of years. Once this vase is shaped, water is added to the area of the vase where it will be removed from the rod after another rod is stuck to the bottom of that piece. From here, the glass is taken to another furnace called the glory hole, which is used to reheat the piece so they can continue shaping it. The amount of times this happens depends on the piece. Here, the glass maker then trims off, removes any unwanted parts, then reheats it again in the glory hole. He then uses his tools to finalize the shape of the vase. Here, the glass maker is using jacks that look like large tweezers to get the vase just right. The piece is again removed from the rod on the bottom and will be taken to the final heated process. The piece is now ready for the annealing process in the layer machine. The piece is carefully placed on a metal belt that moves slowly through the layer. Here the glass piece will take 5 hours from one side to the other. This process allows the glass to slowly cool, which will keep it from cracking or shattering due to thermal stress. As the glass exits the layer, each piece is carefully inspected to ensure it meets the high standards of quality that Blenko is known for. Any pieces that are cracked, broken, or not to specifications are placed into bins where they will be recycled. In fact, Blenko has big plans to begin creating marbles from the recycled glass in the near future.
Here soon, this big pit right here we're building is going to be a marble machine. So we'll take our waste glass, make marbles, will be 100% efficient with our glass cycle.
The pieces that pass inspection are then moved to the cool room where they are polished to give them a smooth finish. At this point, some pieces are custom engraved by adding a piece of vinyl to the glass and sandblasting in the openings. These pieces make great unique gifts. After pieces are finished, they're either placed in the gift shop or in the warehouse while awaiting shipment locally, nationally, and even internationally. Blenko uses expanding foam in their shipping process to ensure products reach customers in one piece. They pride themselves on a shipping efficiency of over 99%. During the 2020-2021 COVID pandemic, these shipments and their collaboration with local artist Liz Pavlovic helped keep Blenko moving forward. 2020 was their most profitable year in two decades. At Blenko, when they say handmade, it goes far beyond the glass itself. From the molds that are hand-carved to even the rods that are used to blow glass, these blowpipes are machined on-site. Everything is carefully made by hand, unlike most things in the world today.
It's just what you did back in the day. It's what glass factories did. You had a bunch of crafty guys, even everything down to their hand tools, they would make those.
You gotta have a six man team, you know. Everybody's gotta work together. Everybody's gotta do their job right to make it, to get to me, you know. Most of us, we grew up together because we've been here so long, you know. Feel like we do. We spend more time here than you do awake with your wife.
Beyond the glass itself, it's the people who have been working at Blenko for decades that passionately carry on the art of glass making. These people strive to keep the company moving onward. So the next time you are in the area, stop by Blenko Glass. They have a great visitor center displaying a variety of pieces for everyone. These pieces each have a story and come in a range of colors, shapes, and sizes, both big and small.
Thanks for checking out Blenko Glass with me right here in Milton, West Virginia. Hope you enjoyed it and keep exploring.